Hi, everybody, and welcome to Teaching Tip Tuesday, brought to you by the Center for Inclusive Teaching and Learning here at UWSP. Generative artificial intelligence. For better or worse, this is a technology that's here to stay. And also, for better or worse, its very existence means that we in higher education need to rethink our approach to teaching students how to engage in background research and writing. Those who get and keep a lot of the jobs that college graduates have traditionally held will be those who can effectively use AI to improve both their speed and the quality of their output. We in higher education should be looking forward to this job landscape and doing what we can to ensure that our students are the ones getting those jobs. Many instructors don't recognize the amount of practice and training it takes to use generative AI effectively. The quality of AI output one receives is directly related to the quality of the prompt they use. To make sure that our students can generate effective prompts when using AI in assignments, it's important to help students recognize the key information that's required to make a prompt effective, to practice writing effective prompts and examining the output, and to provide the opportunity for students to learn about the most common pitfalls in prompt writing. Without knowing them, they can't avoid them. So let's talk about writing AI prompts. One useful way to generate effective prompts is to follow the CREATE model. This stands for Character, Request, Examples, Adjustment, Type of Output, and Extras. Let's go through each of these to see how to create effective AI prompts. First, let's look at character. You should begin your prompt with information on the perspective you want the AI to take, that is, its character. Generative AI doesn't use all of the data that it was trained on when it responds to a prompt. Instead, it needs to locate a specific subset of input sources to draw on. By specifying the character that the AI is supposed to embody, you can help it narrow down its focus on some of the more appropriate material. In some cases, depending on the character, it can also influence the writing style, because generative AI is like fancy predictive text. Drawing exclusively from the works of, say, Hemingway, will alter the pattern of language use that is employed. So the prose will be clean and honest, true and passionate, and will affirm courage and grace under pressure. Some examples of characters include famous authors and scholars, or specific occupations and experience levels. Next, the request. This is what you want the AI to do. It's important to be specific and detailed and include relevant contextual information. Indicate the tone you want. What style or voice should the output use? Should it be persuasive, objective, enthusiastic, friendly, professional, scientific, matter of fact? There are hundreds of choices. Tell the AI who the audience for the output is. Do you want it to be for adults, carpenters, children, students, professionals? AI explaining things to an expert versus to a child will result in drastically different output because the words chosen will be different, the complexity of the information provided will be different. So this is a really important thing to include. Finally, include all the details you want to see in the output. For example, rather than just asking for a cost analysis for a building project in tabular format, you may ask for specific items, like a breakdown of costs for different categories of building materials or projections for what costs will be in 2 years, assuming particular rates of inflation. The more you can detail in your prompt, the better the responses will be. Now, examples. AI does best if you give it something to emulate. If there are existing materials that are similar to what you're looking for from the AI, you can upload excerpts as part of your prompt. Be aware, though, that you still need to respect intellectual property and copyright. If you aren't authorized to use something that somebody else wrote, don't include it in your prompt. Adjustment. Effective use of generative AI may require adjustment or modification of initial prompts based on the output. You can specify aspects of the initial response that you like and those that you don't like to refine the output. You can ask the AI to generate a new output with more like this and less like that. You can ask it to include analogies or examples for specific points. The key here is to remember that you don't always get what you want on the first try. In the CREATE acronym, T stands for the type of output. Be specific about how you want the output organized and formatted. Do you want an essay, an email, a letter, a graph, a table? Do you want bullets, subheadings, column labels, steps, a list? And what length do you want all of this to be? The more that you include, the better the output will be. Finally, the second E in CREATE is for extras. These are details that can provide specific guidance to the AI. So some of the ones that I've seen employed effectively include ask me questions before you answer. This is a great way to get the AI to help you construct some of the elements of the prompt when you aren't sure what things you should want in the output. Ignore everything before this prompt. Large language model generative AI programs are written specifically to include all parts of the conversation that have come before, with the idea that interacting with the AI is a back and forth. Sometimes it's useful to get the AI to just start over, rather than to keep modifying what it's been doing. Finally, you can always ask the AI to explain its thinking. This is a great way to have the AI provide the logical connections between different elements and will often give you a better understanding of how and why the response was generated. Using the CREATE model consistently, it's much easier to learn how to engineer effective AI prompts. Now, generative AI has loads of drawbacks. The best way to avoid pitfalls is to recognize them before you've fallen in. One should never take AI output at face value. Follow the old adage to trust but verify. Remember that AI output is limited both by the nature of the algorithms and by the data used to train them. Biases built into the algorithms are rampant. Both text generation and image generators disproportionately assume white and masculine, leaving women and people of color underrepresented in output. There are also strong biases in language use. Dialects are a mystery to it. For example, you're unlikely to get output written in AAVE unless you specify that you want that. And even then, the AAVE constructs that you get may be flawed. They say AI doesn't do comedy, but playing around with dialects has led me to differ with the experts on this point. Remember that AI is not thinking. It simply returns text similar to the training text. It doesn't understand either your prompt or its response to the prompt. Because of this, the output you receive may not seem to really address the prompt you provided. AI can mimic human conversations very well. Because our brains are wired toward anthropomorphism, it's sometimes easy for us to lose sight of the fact that AI isn't following quite the same rules that humans would. Hallucination is another big problem. This is when AI seems to make up information. It's always important to remember that these algorithms are a lot like predictive text. The AI is putting words together in likely combinations based on parameters and rules. Especially combined with the biased junk information that may have been included in the training materials, the output is sometimes sketchy. Be sure to verify the accuracy of everything that AI generates before using it in any capacity. Finally, remember that AI cannot reflect your unique voice, personality, and style. Part of what makes writing fun and our writings unique is that we all have lived experiences we bring to the table. AI doesn't. Its writing is the verbal equivalent of Wonder Bread. It's palatable, but boring and unmemorable, and it sticks to the roof of your mouth. If you want your work to be a reflection of you, it's important that you don't automatically accept AI output as intrinsically better than what you might write. As an author, your additions, your phrasings, your words, all of those things are what makes reading something fun. As we move forward into a brave new world of generative artificial intelligence, writing better prompts and appropriately revising AI output can help your students get more from AI and prepare them for the careers of tomorrow. And that's this week's teaching tip, brought to you by the Center for Inclusive Teaching and Learning here at UWSP, your one-stop shop for teaching support. Visit our website to schedule a consultation for help with course design, learning activities, assessment, or pedagogy.